Now, Nicodemus can teach us much. You know, this portion of Scripture, we don't think he progressed much at all, but he really, and you'll find this out throughout Trinity season, you'll find out that he had a kind of a understanding. He was almost a secret disciple. You know, it's kind of like when people come into St. Luke's on visitors and they're on holiday, etc. And if they stay here and they worship God and they know what's going on, but they just don't quite know, the seed has been sown. And God only knows what they will be like year, 2, 3 years, but the seed has been sown, and that so likewise it happened to Nicodemus. He can teach us much. We all come to Christ in the dark, don't know too much, and we are all called to allow him to lift us up out of the darkness of our own minds and into the dawn of his redeeming grace. It's a spiritual, symbolic growth that we can experience. Gathering in the Lord's house on the Lord's day, as the sun rises, to feed on his grace, to be forgiven of our sins, to partake of the outpoured cup and the broken bread, so that we can live life filled with his grace and presence, and so that in the sweet by and by we will have that which Jesus offers us in today's gospel narrative, eternal life.